So we discussed the different paths, different nodes, what are the feedback loop, what are the self loop, what is path gain, what are the properties, then how to convert system equation into signal flow graph. We also discussed Meissen's gain formula, and with the help of the Meissen's gain formula, how to calculate the transfer function, and we did one example. So we'll practice some more so that you'll get a grip on that. So this is a formula for the transfer function, that is T1 delta 1 plus T2 delta 2 divided by the delta. And you know what is T1, that is the gain of the first forward path, T2, that is the gain of the second forward path, then delta 1, that is it is touching, non-touching loops. So I'll explain. T1 part is clear, that is simple. So delta 1 and delta I will explain again. So you have to first find out the loops, non-touching loops and touching loops. So what is delta? Delta is nothing but 1 minus sum of all the loops including self loop and plus product of loops, that is non-touching loops. So let us see. L1. So L1 is this, and I have shown you separately. This is L1, and the gain of L1 is G4 and H1. Then L2 is this. This is L2 that is shown like this, and gain of the L2 is G3, G4, G5 and H2 negative. Then L3 is like this. This is L3. It has to be, what we are discussing, we are discussing about the feedback loops. So L3, the gain of the L3 will be minus G2 and H2 into H2. Now, this L1 and L3. That is, this L1 and L3, they are non-touching, whereas L1 and L2, see, this is L1 and this is L2, they are touching. Similarly, L3 and L2, they are touching. L2 is this and L3 is this, so they are touching loops. So now delta is equal to 1 minus sum of all the loops, whether touching, non-touching. It is 1 minus sum of all the loops including the self loops. Self loop, you know, it's like this self loop. Self loop will have only one node. And then here you have product of plus product of two non-touching loops. Now, which are the two non-touching loops? That is L1 and L3, these are the two non-touching loops. So, gain, that is delta, is equal to 1 minus L1 plus L2 plus L3 and plus L1 into L3. Now delta 1, how to find out the delta 1? Delta 1 you have to find out, eliminate L1, L2, L3. As all are touching to T1. So what is this delta 1 is? Value of this delta. Value of this delta. See, first thing is delta you have to find out. Value of this delta by eliminating all the loop guns which are touching to the kth forward pulse. Okay, so that is first. Kth forward pulse means first forward pulse, right? So you have to see which are touching to T1. Okay. So L1 is touching to T1, L2 is also touching to T2, and L3 is also touching to T1. So all L1, L2, L3 are touching to T1. Okay. So you have to eliminate those. That means you have to take it as zero. So L1 0, L2 0, L3 0. Okay. So you have to substitute now 0, 0, and here you have to substitute. So you will get this answer as delta 1 as equal to 1. Now delta 2. Okay. Delta 2 is you have to find out now path number 2. What is path number 2? That is T2. T2, that is G1, G2, G6. G1, G2 and G6. So this is what is your path number 2. This forward path, G1, G2, G6. That is your forward path. And now you have to see the loops which are touching to the forward path number 2. So obviously which are touching, now this is L1 is not touching, this is your forward path. So this loop is touching, that is L2. L2 is nothing but this and L3. L2 and L3, your L3 was like this and L2 is like this. So L2 and L3 are touching to the path. So you will take that value as 0 and substitute. So L2 and L3, so that's 0, and here you substitute L3 as 0, so this will be 0. So answer will be 1 minus L1 delta 2. So now you have to substitute in Mason's gain formula, that is T1 delta 1 plus T2 delta 2. So this is how delta is found out, that is 1 minus summation of all individual feedback loop gains plus summation of gain product of all possible combination of two non-touching loops. And this you don't bother because such a big question will not come. Let's see now this. Find the transfer function, that is response, which is given by C of S divided by the disturbance, that is R of S, for signal flow graph, which is shown in the following figure. Okay, so this is your G1, G2, G3, G4, and here gain is given as 1, here gain is given as 1. Then you have, this is forward path, then you have one, this is feedback loop, this is one feedback loop, and this is one feedback loop. So you have three feedback loops and identify now the forward path. So how many forward paths are there? Obviously only two. One is straight going from here to here, and another is from here to here and then to the response. So there are only two forward paths. I hope it is clear. There are only two forward paths. One is straight like this, and then another is like this. So what is the gain of first forward path T1? That is 1 into G1 into G2 into G3 into G4 into 1. So that will be G1, G2, G3, G4. What about second forward path? That is T2. That will be 1 into G1 into G5 into 1. So that will be G1, G5. I repeat again, second forward path, 1 into G1 into G5 into 1. Now we will check the feedback loops. See the feedback loops. So let's see L1. So L1 is this. And what will be the gain for the L1? G1, G2 and this. H3. And since this is negative feedback, so it will be minus G1, G2, G3. Then L2 will be G1 minus G1, G2, H2. And then L3 will be minus G4, H1. And then you have L4. Okay, so now be careful about L4. So L4 will be like this. This way, and again coming this way. So that is what is your L4 is. This, this, and this. So gain for the L4 will be G5. Then H1 and then H2, and this minus minus, that will be plus minus into minus. So we'll have plus G5 into H1, H2. Now we'll find out the delta, that is gain for all the loops. So that is given by 1 minus summation of all the loops. So that is L1, L2, L3, L4 plus product of non-touching loops. So now you have to product of non-touching. Now you have to identify which are the non-touching loops. Now L1, L2, L3, L4. Now look carefully. L1, L2, L3, L4. Look in the main drawing now. Where it is gone? This. So this is L1. L1 is like this. So L1 and L4, they are touching. So you have to ignore that. And L1 and L2 also, they are overlapped. So obviously you have to ignore that. So now you see, this is one L1 and this is L3. So L1 and L3, they are non-touching loops. They are not touching each other. So these are the two non-touching loops, that is L1, L3. So L1 into L3, product of two non-touching loops. Now you got to add now L1, L2, L3, L4 plus L1 into L3. So whatever gains you have written here, that we need to substitute. So you get this. Now find out T1 and T2. Find out T1 and T2. So what is T1 and T2? We know already T1 and T2 is what we have seen earlier example. Eliminate L1, L2, L3 as all are touching to. So you have to see, eliminate L2, L3. Which are the touching? or rather you have to identify the loop which are non or which are not touching to forward path 1. So now delta 1, so identify the loop which is not touching to the forward path 1. So this is forward path to L1. L1 is touching, it's rather overlap. L2, that is also overlap. L3 overlap, L4. So all will be 0. L1 is equal to 0, L2 is equal to 0, L3 is equal to 0, L4 is equal to 0. So delta 1 will be, substitute here 0, 0, 0, here 0 into 0. So you will get only 1. So delta 1 is equal to 1. And similarly, delta 2 also will be equal to 0. Now next is just substitute, that's all. And then finish. Let's go for this now. So again, how many forward path? This is one forward path. Another, this is another forward path, that is 1 into G5 into G4 into 1. That is second forward path. First forward path is simple, that is G1, G2, G3, G4 into 1. This is feedback. Now we have to identify the feedback loops. So this is one feedback loop and this is another feedback loop. So this feedback loop, what will be the gain? G2 into H1. And for this feedback loop, what will be the gain? G1, G2, G3, G4 into H2. Is there any more loop? Yes. See now. This is the third one. That's the twist in this question. So you have one more loop. That is nothing but this. You have to find out all possible feedback loops. Okay, so you got L1, you got L2, and you got L3. You got the gains also. Yeah. So now, sum of all the loops, and here, product of non-touching loops. Now you see which are the non-touching loops. Now, if you see this and this, they are overlapping, L1 and L2. L1 and L2, L1 is over here. L1 is over here. So, they are overlapping. So, that means they are touching. Now, look at this. Another combination. You have to take two loops together, two non-touching loops. Now, you have to look at this. L1. L1 is yahan pe center mein. And L3 is over here, that is outside. So L1 and L3, they are non-touching. You can see here, this is what is your L1 is, L1, and this is your L3 is like this, Aisa. Whereas look at L1 and L2, L1 is like this, and L2 is like this. So they are overlapped. So that means two non-touching loop, that is nothing but L1 and L3. So it is L1 and 2, L3. Now, we have T1. Now, see. Now, we have to find out the delta 1 and delta 2. Okay. So, delta 1 means you have to consider the first forward path over here. Now, this is the first forward path. It is very simple. L1 is touching overlap. L2 is also touching, that is overlap, and L3 is also overlap, that is touching over here. So here L1, L2, L3 will be 0. That means your delta 1 will be 1. Now delta 2, so second forward path. So second forward path is this and like this. Okay. So now your L1 is touching, your L3 is also touching. Look at this. Your L1, second forward path is like this. So in this case, your which loop is not touching? L1. L2 is touching and your L3 is also touching. So L1 is not touching to the second forward path, which is shown here. Okay. So L1 is not touching to the second forward path. Here this path is not shown. So we will say L1 is not touching to the T2, that is this. L1 is not touching to the second forward path. L2 and L3 both are touching. This is your L2. L2 is also touching and this is your L3. L3 though it is very clearly superimposed on the second forward path, and that is L3, and L2 is touching over here and touching over here. So you have to take that as 0, L2 and L3. So you have now only 1 minus L1. And substitute. And this is the forward transfer function. Okay, so this is the end of the signal flow guide. So you submit question number this, example number 34. Understand it properly, write it properly, neatly, and submit it. If you have any doubt, you please ask. I hope it is clear. Ready? Hello?
Yes, sir, no doubt.
Okay, okay. Thank you so much. We'll stop for the day.